Good morning. Welcome into First Take. Thank you so much for being with us. Let's get right into it here. Jon Gruden resigned as head coach of the Raiders in the wake of his racist, misogynistic, and anti-gay emails being exposed during an investigation of the Washington football team. He announced his resignation in a statement on Monday night, shortly after the New York Times reported that he used misogynistic and anti-gay language in numerous emails during a seven-year period that ended in 2018. The Times story came after our Adam Schefter reported the NFL had sent the Raiders additional Gruden emails to review emails that were on top of the one that surfaced last week, in which Gruden used a racist comment in referring to NFLPA executive director Demora Smith, and other emails in which Gruden disparaged NFL commissioner Roger Goodell with a vulgar description. The Raiders said assistant Rich Bisaccia will serve as interim coach. As you can see, Jon Gruden put out that statement on your screen. I've resigned as head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. I love the Raiders and do not want to be a distraction. Thank you to all the players, coaches, staff, and fans of Raider Nation. I'm sorry. I never meant to hurt anyone. Raiders owner Mark Davis adding, I have accepted Jon Gruden's resignation as head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. Interesting timing. These emails were sent while Jon Gruden was working for ESPN as a lead analyst for Monday Night Football, and his resignation announced during Monday Night Football last night. Keyshawn is getting set to join us right now. Obviously, he just finished his radio show. He played with a unique perspective, playing 2 years under Jon Gruden. We will get to him momentarily. Welcome into First Take. Thank you for being here. I'm Molly Karam Rose, Stephen A. Smith. I'll start with you, Stephen A., as Keyshawn gets set here.
Yes.
What's your reaction to all of this? Because this was shocking. As I was watching the game, it was really coming down throughout and at halftime.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, by the way, everybody, like you said, Keyshawn will be here in a second. Just
yep.
changing.
Walking out right now.
Radio,
yep.
Just finished doing his radio show. I got to get this out of my ear. So much static's in my ear right now. To say that this is stunning doesn't even begin to describe what this situation is.
Yeah.
Let me get this out of the way first.
Real quick, Keyshawn is here. Good morning. Thank you for being with us.
Brother?
Thank
oh, yeah.
you
What's
for
that?
The hustle.
Sure. No problem.
And grateful to have you.
Yeah, absolutely grateful. Thanks a lot. To say that this is stunning doesn't even begin to describe how we all should feel right now. Couple of things. Number one, yesterday, mm-hmm. you weren't here. I was of the mindset that Jon Gruden shouldn't be fired, shouldn't be suspended, because it was one email from 2011. Mm-hmm. And then the next thing you know, this avalanche arrived last night.
Mm-hmm.
And you learned that it wasn't one email, but many. You learned it wasn't one email that happened in 2011. It was emails that started in like 2010 all the way to 2011, all the way to 2018. And let's get into the particulars, because before I even say all of that, let me say this. Jon Gruden's career is over. It's over. There's certain things that we are the land of second chances. People mm-hmm. make mistakes all the time, and we get all of that. But I cannot imagine even a white male with influence and connections and some degree of power that can overcome what the New York Times reported and what we all now know. Jon Gruden made racially insensitive comments about Demora Smith, the executive director of the Players Association. And you have a plethora of people in this country that felt that should have been enough. Then we learned that he was against the NFL bringing in a guy like Michael Sam, saying over via emails that the commissioner should not be encouraging then Rams coach Jeff Fisher to draft queers. Then he sat up there, and after all of that, what did he say after that? He goes off, he calls the commissioner the P word. He calls the vice president of the United States the P word. He's against women being officials in the National Football League. I mean, you're insulted blacks, you insulted women, you insulted folks from the gay community. The list
Wait,
just
and
went
criticized
on and on.
Player safety.
And criticized. I was getting.
And
I was
trying
getting
to reduce.
Oh,
the
I wasn't finished. I wasn't
okay.
finished. I was saving
I
that.
Just wanted to make sure.
Eric Reed, you know, he said that Eric Reed should be fired for exercising his constitutional rights, because he had every right to do what he did, whether people agree with him or not. The fact of the matter is, you had a right to do it. He said the man should be fired. Everywhere you turn, I mean, he has offended, several groups of people. His career is over. There's certain things, particularly in this day and age, you don't come back from. And Jon Gruden cannot come back from this. So before I say, I want to hand it off to you, Keyshawn, because I think your words right now are more important than mine because you played for the man and you were consistent. Like I said yesterday, even when I said, listen, he shouldn't be fired based off of the one comment from 2011. I made sure to point out that your words yesterday on your radio show, before anybody has spoken about it, your words, I was like, Keyshawn's been saying this about him for years. Everything he said on the radio, Keyshawn said about Jon Gruden years and years ago. So your words were very, very consistent. And now they're prophetic and profound, to be quite honest with you. I don't see how he gets away with this. I don't see how he comes back from this. He hasn't gotten away from it, but how he comes back from this. But he ain't the only one. You, Bruce Allen, you know, you don't have a job right now. Good luck in getting one. Some of these groups, the owner of Hooters, and this little chain, this little clique y'all had going, you know, sending these emails back and forth with one another. This will not be the only domino that will fall.
It's never the only domino that will fall. Yeah. I mean, it's just the start of everything. I don't even know. What do you start with this situation?
Any you know, you want.
I want to start here. What did you see? What did
years
you
ago?
See as a player? Because you've been saying this for years, and people were critical of you for having those opinions.
I would say this, Molly. When I was playing,
yeah.
I didn't say anything. Stephen A. remember when I was deactivated from the team and essentially sent home for 6-7 weeks,
yeah.
I didn't say anything. I said, hey, I'm happy. I won a Super Bowl. I had my time. It's time to move on. I didn't get into it. I let everybody else just say what they say. And then I finally said, man, this dude is a fraud. Y'all don't seem to understand he's selling you on something and you're buying it. He's been doing that for years. And whether it was he's an excellent quarterback coach, whether he won the Super Bowl, which I'm grateful and thankful that he came in at a time and injected some energy into us so we can get over the hump that year and win the Super Bowl. But it's the talking behind people's back. That was one of his traits in Tampa. Everything, Stephen A., I love you. I love you, Molly. You're great. But as soon as I go around the corner, I can't stand them you-know-whats and this, that, and the other. I got to get – he was doing that a lot. And you know how assistant coaches are. Assistant coaches have to feed their family, so they're not going to say nothing.
Right.
But they'll tell you on the side.
That's right.
Hey, dude, this dude here is a bad guy.
Yeah.
And I always try to tell people, man, that dude's a bad guy. Y'all don't seem to get it because he gets on television – and he has the scrawl on his face and everybody likes him because he won a championship. I had take no personal feelings with me at all about Jon Gruden. The guy actually tried to get me to come back to play for him the first year I retired. Bruce Allen and him called me and my agent to try to get me to come back and play for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers to make another playoff run, and I decided to stay at ESPN instead. But I also understood who he was. Am I surprised that this sort of behavior would come out about Coach Gruden? I'm not surprised that he would talk about people in despairing views behind their backs. Not at all. Am I surprised that he used racial insensitive things? Am I surprised that he was acting homophobic situations, talking about the LGBT community? Am I surprised that he went after the vice president, went after the commissioner? No. I'm not surprised, but what I'm surprised about is some of the words that he used. Because I never saw that side of him, Molly.
Yeah.
I can't sit here and tell you that he called somebody out their name. I never saw that. But as far
it sounds
as...
like to your face, it was always positive.
It was
that
a
was
positive
kind of a
thing yeah. because I kept it positive, mm-hmm. but I also saw through the stuff that he was putting out there. Mm-hmm. And it's always been that way. It's a funny story. You'll laugh at this, though, too, Stephen A. Prior to him taking... This is why I say a fraud and phony. Prior to him taking a job with ESPN, it was reported. Prior to taking a job with the Raiders, he was at ESPN. It was widely reported. He's going to ESPN. 3 weeks before,
going to the Raiders job.
Going to the Raiders. Jon Gruden called me. I'm talking to John. Normal. We had an hour conversation about building the staff and about and about the players and the defense on the team. Why? But he wanted to know about a guy that I knew that he wanted to bring on his staff. But I knew that was all phony. I'm like, why are you calling me about a team? And he says, well, if I take the job, I don't think I'm going to take the job. You already done agreed to take the damn job. But that's who he is. And you have to know that and take it with face value and deal with it that way. Now, as far as all the emails go, in the insensitive language in those emails, he's dead wrong. And what happened to him yesterday should have happened. And you and I had a sidebar conversation. Yeah. And you told me, Stephen A., you said, no, you're wrong, Keyshawn.
Right.
You told me that. I said,
Stephen A. Over that one email. Yeah.
Over that one email. That's right. I said, no, man, there's going to be more that's going to come.
Right. And that's what you said.
He said, man, it's going to be more that's going to come.
Right.
If they got 650,000 emails reported, you mean to tell me only one email? Mm-hmm. No. They had a whole 7-year span.
Do you think he can never come back from this, similar to the sentiment Stephen A. said earlier?
Oh, he'll never coach again.
No.
Not in the National Football League.
Never.
Now, if you ask me if some college to some certain region or something like that, because they feel that certain way, they might in college, but in the pros, no, because it's very difficult to look us in the eyes and say to us, we need to play for you and you need to be our leader.
Right. First of all, let me get some names out here because I'm reading from the article, the New York Times here. Sure. Ed Drost, D-R-O-S-T-E. I don't know if that's the correct pronunciation. The co-founder of Hooters.
Yeah, co-founder of Hooters.
Jim McVay, an executive who has run the Outback Bowl, annually held in Tampa, Florida, where Jon Gruden lives.
I believe that's the uncle of Sean McVay.